What's up, guys? My name is Brandon, and today Apple finally released macOS 11 Big Sur after almost 5 months of beta testing. So in this video, I wanted to share my top favorite features in this all new redesigned version of macOS. And if you take a look at the size of this update, you could see here it came in around 12 gigabytes on my 2017 5K iMac, which came from macOS Catalina. So the size will vary depending on your Mac and the version you are coming from. Also, a quick note, if you were on the beta program, RC2 is different from the final release. So if you were on the RC2, the release candidate 2 of Big Sur, you will have to update again to get to the final version here of Big Sur. So anyways, let's go ahead and get into my personal favorite features here in macOS 11 Big Sur. And the first one is going to be AirPods auto switching. So this finally works with the Mac now. This was a feature in iOS and iPadOS 14 that I really loved, and now it works flawlessly on the Mac thanks to Big Sur. So what this does is basically it just switches between all of your different Apple devices depending on which one is actually playing media or music at the time. So if I stick my AirPods in my ears, you will also see that we get a little icon up here in the status bar. You can see we have a new AirPods Pro icon up there, and the AirPods will actually switch to, you know, my iPhone, my iPad, my iMac, or my MacBook, depending on which one is playing the music or the video at the time. So it's really nice to have the auto switching feature now come to macOS Big Sur. Now, speaking of sounds and music, you can also see a new icon here in the status bar that's a little play icon. And if you tap on that, you can see this is where it shows the media that is currently playing. So it shows that I'm playing this song right now in Apple Music, but it can also show like if I'm playing audio from a certain tab. So like if I go ahead and open up Safari and go to YouTube, and you can see I'm playing this video right here. And then if we go up to the menu bar and tap on that little plus right there, you can see that we have two different sources right here. So we can choose, you know, which source we want to play on our Mac or in our AirPods. So if I press play on this, it'll start playing the music. Or if I press play on the video, it will start playing the video. So really cool new toggle, new little feature there up in the menu bar. Another great new feature in macOS Big Sur is going to be battery optimization for the MacBook. So if we go into our system preferences and then go to battery right here, and then go to battery over on the side right here, you will see that we have optimized battery charging. And it says to reduce battery aging, your Mac learns from your daily charging routine, so it can wait to finish charging past 80% until you need to use it on battery. So that's a great new feature that will prolong the battery life of the MacBooks. And actually, if we tap on the battery icon up here in the menu bar, it will actually show, you know, that it's waiting to fully charge as well once it gets to 80%. So right now I'm on 50%, but it will show after 80%, you know, when it's going to fully charge to 100%. So this is great to have for all MacBooks. Now, going back to system preferences, if we go into our desktop and screensaver right here, you'll see that we have a lot of new wallpapers in Big Sur. So you can see we have these dynamic ones, which do change throughout the day. So you can see this is just Big Sur right there, and you can have this set to dynamic. So it will change once again throughout the day, depending on, you know, how light or dark it is outside. We also have the wallpapers from like iOS and iPadOS 14.2. So we have like these kind of animated looking wallpapers here as well. We have the dark mode version as well. Then we just have a lot of different wallpapers. This is probably my favorite right here. It's called the Big Sur Shore Rocks. This is probably my favorite wallpaper. Looks really good, but we just have a lot of different wallpapers from Big Sur, which look excellent on these displays. So really love the wallpapers this year. So you can expect to find a lot of new wallpapers here in Big Sur. Now, we also have a lot of new sound effects here in macOS Big Sur. So like if we take a screenshot, we'll get a new sound here in this latest macOS version. If we do things like empty the trash or move things to the trash, we'll have new sounds for that. Just a lot of new sounds throughout the OS. We also get the startup chime back. So if you go into your settings here, and then if we go to sound, you will see right here underneath the volume bar, it says play sound on startup. So there you go. You do also have the toggle for play user interface sound effects, which I would recommend because that's pretty much what I just talked about, the new sound effects here in Big Sur. So some nice new sounds added in this latest update. Now, if we go all the way up to the top into the menu bar, you will see these two little icons right here, and that's going to be for the control center. So for the first time in macOS, we have a control center just like we do with the iPhone and the iPad, and it looks very similar. A lot of these elements look very similar as well. And you can see you can change, you know, a lot of things from here, your Wi-Fi, your Bluetooth, your AirDrop, You have your keyboard brightness, screen mirroring, do not disturb. You have all these different things you can change from here. You also have a little AirPlay icon right here, so you can AirPlay the sound really easily from the control center. And the best part about this is that you can actually drag these control center icons to the menu bar itself. So like if you wanted to have quick and easy access to the keyboard brightness without having to go into the control center and then clicking on keyboard brightness, we can actually drag this up to the menu bar right here and let go. And you can see now we have that quick little toggle there to change the keyboard brightness, which is very, very useful for the MacBook. And of course we can do that with anything. So like the Wi-Fi, the Bluetooth, we can drag all of these up there. Screen mirroring, we can do that as well. All of these can be up there in the menu bar for quick and easy access. So I really, really love the new control center, and it really makes you feel like, you know, you're just kind of using the iPhone or the iPad, but just on a bigger screen, of course, on a computer. But everything just seems a lot more familiar now with macOS Big Sur, and I think the control center has a lot to do with that. And another element that has macOS Big Sur feeling a lot like iOS and iPadOS is going to be the notification center. So if we go ahead and tap right here, if we go ahead and click on the date over here on the right, you will see that we have the notification center right here. Then we also have the widgets down below that. So this also looks very similar to like iPadOS. So you can see, first of all, we have the notification center here. I have two messages and you can see they are grouped. So we now get grouped notifications here in macOS Big Sur. And actually, if you know, right click or double click right here on the notification, you can get different options here as well. So you can deliver quietly, you could turn off, then you also have notification preferences, which will take you into your preferences right here. And you could change, you know, whatever you want to right there. But the notification center looks a lot better, a lot more clean. And the notification bubbles themselves also look a lot better here in Big Sur. Then again, we do have the widgets down here, which you can move around as you please. Again, very similar, a lot more similar to iPadOS versus iOS, but you can also tap on the edit widgets down here at the bottom. And this will go ahead and show you all of the different widgets you can add. And you can just drag these over if you want to and place them where you want, which is nice. And I do also hope that we see some third-party widgets very soon. I'm assuming we will, but that'll be nice to have over here as well. And of course, you do have the different sizes as well. So you can see small, medium. You have a large version for the notes right there, and you have these different sizes. Again, very similar, just a slightly different layout compared to iOS and iPadOS. Now, my next favorite feature in Big Sur is going to be the ability to play 4K videos in Safari. So before, you would not be able to play 4K videos. You could only play up to 1080p for some reason, but now you can play full 4K videos and even 8K videos when it's supported in Safari. So before, I would just have to use Google Chrome to watch 4K videos. That was one of the main reasons I didn't even use Safari, is because I could not watch YouTube videos in 4K, but now you can. So that is good news if you watch YouTube videos, which I'm assuming most of you do. Now we also get some major improvements to the Spotlight search. So if we command space and pull up the Spotlight search here, you will notice that we get much better results for everything. So no matter what we search, whether it's like an application or something where we have files on here, or if it's something like, I don't know, bread, just type something randomly like that, you will notice that you get a lot more from this search. So you can see a lot more in here, and it also carries over to the Finder as well. So if we search, like I'll just say Final Cut, if I just search for Final Cut like that, you can see we just get a lot more in the search results. So there's not a ton there just because I don't, you know, edit too much on this, but even if we don't press enter, if we just type in Final Cut, you can see we get a lot more results returned than we did in Catalina. So really nice there, the improvements to the universal search or the Spotlight search, and then also in Finder. Now we also get a lot of new features in Safari in macOS Big Sur. So right away, right when I open up Safari, you could probably tell a pretty big difference. So we have our favorites right here. We have our privacy report, which once again is just like iOS and iPadOS, which shows us, you know, how many things Safari has blocked, how many trackers Safari has blocked from websites. I'll talk about that in a moment. We have our reading list, and then we have the handoff section right here. And if you go ahead and click on these little arrows, you can see you could choose handoff from different devices. So you can see this is what I have on my iPhone 12 Pro right now. Then this is what I have going on my iMac in terms of web pages that I have open. So that's really nice to have there and be able to go in between those. Now, also, like I said, the privacy report, if you go ahead and click on this, it will show you, you know, where Safari has blocked trackers from, like the different websites and the specific trackers. So this is a lot of things like, you know, like Google Ads and just, you know, advertisements and things like that. It will show how many it blocked right here. And it gives you some nice stats for the last 30 days and things like that. Very similar to what we've seen on iOS and iPadOS. I don't need to go too deep into that. But also here in Safari on the bottom right, you'll see this little control toggle here on the bottom right. and you can go ahead and, you know, take some things off of this starting page if you want to. So like if you don't want your favorites to be there, just simply unclick it like so. And of course you could change all these as well to your liking. Then down here you also have the ability to add a custom background image. So you can see when I delete it, when I uncheck it, it deletes the background image. If I reselect it, you can see it goes right there. So we have some preset ones in here, or you can add your own background image to Safari. And you can see you get some pretty cool ones there. Kind of makes Safari just look a little bit more lively. If we tap on the plus right here, this is where we can add our own if we want to. So I went ahead and opened up a few tabs, and you can see that if we hover over one of these tabs, it will now show us a preview. So we now get a preview of every tab, and it pulls up pretty much instantly, which is really nice. So that is a cool new feature. Also, if we go to a site with a different language, we have translation built in now. Just like iOS and iPadOS, macOS, Big Sur, and the new Safari will now translate things in real time if you are on a website in a different language. So you can see here, if I go to the Spanish version of ESPN, we now get a new little icon here in the address bar. It looks like a translation. So if you go ahead and click on that, you can see it says translate to English or preferred languages. You can change that right there. So if I go ahead and translate to English, it will take a second to reload. Then it will show everything, as you can see, in English. And if you want to go back again, click on it and view original. So that's really nice now to have built in to Safari. And then also Safari is just overall much faster here in Big Sur than it was previously. And the fact that we have all these new features makes me actually want to use Safari now, especially the 4K in YouTube. It actually makes me want to use Safari now over something like Google Chrome. Not to mention, we do also get some Safari extensions in the App Store. So if we go ahead and open up the App Store, so let me go ahead and do that real quick. Inside of the App Store, we have a new section for these right here. So if we go to our categories over here on the left, you can see we have Safari extensions right here. If you click on that, it will show you these different extensions you can add to Safari, which is pretty nice. Now, two of the applications that I really never used on macOS before that I use now in Big Sur are both the Messages app and also the Maps application. Both of those I actually use now because macOS Big Sur brought so many great new updates to those applications. So let's start off with Messages right here. So you'll be able to tell right away that this looks a lot more similar to the iOS and iPadOS version of Messages than it did previously. So also when we go to type something right here, you can see we have the A right here, so the app icon right there. If you go ahead and tap on that, you can see we can add photos, we have emoji stickers, you can add GIFs here from the computer, which you never could do that before. You also have message effects, you could never do that before. So you can send all these different things. Then you also have the emoji button right here on the right to easily send emojis as well. So just a lot of great new features here with Messages that actually makes it worth using now on the Mac. And then also if we go into a group chat, you could change things in the group chat as well. So like if you wanted to change the picture, if you wanted to change the name of the group, you can now do all of that here thanks to macOS Big Sur. Again, just like you could with iOS and iPadOS 14. And you also get features like replying to individual people and adding reactions and things like that. So if you right click, you can see you have reply right there, you have tap back, then you have all these different options here inside of Messages. So once again, it's finally worth using Messages now on a Mac, whereas it really never was for me before. And it's the same deal with the Maps application. I now finally feel like there's a reason to use it on macOS Big Sur. So number one, we can zoom in on something and click on the 3D button right here. You can kind of get a 3D look, which is pretty cool. You also have things like the route planner. You could do that for biking. You have, you know, EV tripping. So if you have like a Tesla or an electric car, you can plan out your route here inside of the Maps application on Big Sur now. And you have guides as well. So if we click on something like this Fisherman's Wharf right here, you will see different guides pop up right here. Basically just things to do around San Francisco and Fisherman's Wharf, different things like that. So you can also create your own guide by clicking on the plus right here and create new guide. And you can also add new place too right there as well. So some nice new features here in Big Sur. And then if you zoom in enough, you will unlock the new look around feature, which is right here. If you click on that, and you will see we get a little window up in the top left, and this actually shows you what it looks like in real life. So you can see here, really, really cool. It uses Google Maps, or actually uses Apple Maps, and it shows, you know, it'll show you like where things are. You can go up a little bit if you want to. So if you click on it, it works just like Google Maps does. And this is really cool to see, you know, what it looks like, what it actually looks like there instead of just looking at it on the map. So really cool new features here on macOS Big Sur. with the Maps application. Another one of my favorite features in Big Sur is just the fact that everything is so uniformed. So just like in Finder, we have this sidebar right here. It looks the same throughout all of the default applications, just like it does in iPadOS 14. So I think that looks really good. Also, I love the new design of Big Sur. So you've probably noticed it all throughout this video, but we have all new icons down here in the dock. The dock itself is slightly different as well. It's, you know, kind of floating now. So you can see the bottom of the dock instead of it just kind of being stuck down to the bottom. So that looks really well. And we also have the translucent top bar here as well. The menu bar looks a lot different. You know, we have a lot of differences here. Siri has a little bit of a different look. The control center, everything just looks so much better. This design looks so much more modern than it did on Catalina. We have the little, you know, colors right here next to Recents, desktop, and all that. Just everything. I love the design of Big Sur, and it's really hard to go back to Catalina after using this for a while. Now, another nice new feature in macOS Big Sur is that Time Machine backups now use APFS instead of HFS by default. And this is going to lead to much faster and more reliable backups, which is nice because if you've ever used Time Machine, you know how long those backups can take. But now, if you use APFS, it will be a lot faster than it was previously by default when it used HFS. And then finally, the last feature I wanted to talk about in this video is that the new Apple Silicon M1 Max can run iOS and iPadOS applications thanks to Big Sur, and of course, thanks to the M1 chip inside of those new Macs. So I will be testing that here on the channel when I get those new MacBooks and the Mac Mini in the studio, but that is a great new feature. You can now run iOS and iPadOS apps. So that's gonna be really, really cool to see. But anyways, guys, there you have it. Those are some of my favorite new features here in macOS 11 Big Sur. So if you guys enjoyed this video, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you guys subscribe for a lot more content coming very soon on the new Apple Silicon Macs and things like that. So anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.